The owner of Area Mechanicals. We started this little shop back in October of last year. We were first an online business and then we started to get in more into the retail shop side. So yeah, let's look around.
Okay, cool. Because this is my first time here and I'm so glad that I came here because I see so many cool plants here.
Yeah, this is one of my favorites right now. This is Monstera carcinino, or species Peru. It's not scientifically identified yet.
Right.
It's a really cool species of Monstera.
It's growing really fast, right? Because I have one. It's, yeah, like, it's growing like crazy. Yeah.
This is another one of my favorites too, Philodendron Jungle Boogie.
Right.
Really easy houseplant too.
Right.
Diffenbachia Reflector.
Yes.
Real nice foliage.
Yes, I'm getting one.
This is one of our shop plants, Anthurium papilinianum.
Oh.
It's a species endemic to Panama.
Right,
this one has that really nice, large, velvety foliage.
Right, yeah. So I see this one too. This one, what's the name of this, Sansevieria? Yes.
This is Sansevieria sayuri.
Oh,
so you get
okay.
The nice like white grayish tones.
Right.
Really cool.
It looks a little bit like the bento sensation.
Yes, yes.
But like yeah, I don't have this one. I wish this one was smaller.
Me too.
Yeah. Oh, Jewel Orchid?
Yeah, oh. Just see a discolor.
Oh, yeah. I have one, but mine is tiny.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
yeah,
the so leaves cool. Are so pretty. And this?
Yeah,
yes.
This is a string of dolphins, or Senecio pangerinus, I think.
Right, yeah.
And it's a hybrid of string of pearls and Senecio articulatus.
Oh, okay, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
And you have great prices too, like
thank
on
you.
This. Yeah, because I only saw it at a nursery before,
yeah.
And it was much more expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
This is another really cool one too. If you're into begonias,
oh.
This is Begonia escargot.
Oh, okay.
It's a really cool Rex hybrid. You can kind of see the blue in there. Yeah.
Oh,
so
okay, yeah.
Yeah, you get the nice little swirl too.
Oh. Yeah, the leaves are really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Another cool one. Alocasia stingray.
Right. And there's also the baby one, right? Baby
yeah,
stingray.
Yeah, baby ray. This
yeah.
Is so cute. This one is a really cool penda anthurium. Anthurium pulindifolium.
Uh-huh.
It's an epiphytic type of anthurium, so it's
kind of
grow on
trees.
Oh,
I see.
And they can get leaves about 6 feet long, too.
Oh, wow. Okay. How big is your personal collection?
We have probably, I want to say, like 60 to 70 plants at home.
Oh, okay.
For more on the small side, we had like a lot more before we moved here.
Right.
And just kind of like withered away. We kind of withered out our favorites out of the cupboard.
Right. So what are your favorite plants right now, or favorite genera?
I'm really into begonias right now,
oh.
And also Hoyas are really exciting me too.
Right.
Yeah, I love begonias. And then also, I'm a sucker for any of the weird philodendrons too.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. My like top wish list plant, I think, is Philodendron Torridum right now. It's
oh,
a really cool one.
Okay.
Really jagged leaf.
Right.
One.
And maybe you can talk a little bit about this Monstera?
Yeah, this is just a big old totem of Monstera. It's like half of it is just a normal Monstera deliciosa borsigniana. So it's
right.
A slightly smaller leaf variety.
Right.
And then there's a little bit of variegated Monstera in it.
Yes.
Ah. You can see a cool little splotch
right, this
right
one
in
is...
there. Yeah.
Yeah, with begonias, I don't know why I'm not super. I don't know.
You should look up Begonia papinina. It's a really cool one, but it has like iridescent blue and like
right.
A special flashlight.
Right.
And that's what really got me hooked, just because there's so much variety in,
right.
In species and in the Rex hybrids too.
I feel like I should like begonias just because I'm a foliage lover,
mm-hmm.
But for some reason.
Just haven't gotten into
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah.
That's how I felt.
I only have a few.
Yeah. I wish I knew the name of it, but it looks like very fall colors.
Right, yeah.
And then we got a tiger paws.
Oh, this one's cool.
It's so cute.
Oh, I love the colors.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I like this Calathea.
That is Calathea misto.
Yeah, it's really pretty. So, like, do you feel like this one is finicky? Because I feel like I had better luck with some Calatheas than the others. So,
yeah,
do you feel
this one I find is a little easier in terms of like humidity?
Right.
The one thing is they do like to stay more on the moist side,
right?
And they don't need any direct sun either. I think this one actually is one of the components to Calathea White Fusion. I think this is the all green version.
Right. White Fusion is definitely finicky.
Yeah.
Oh, that one's easy
to
kill.
That one just needs to be like under a cloche in the darkness.
Right.
You're just like very happy.
Do you use filter water?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I found they are very sensitive to like any chlorine content or any hard water too.
Right. Yeah, I think that's a trick.
Yeah.
So yeah, this curly ficus, I just got it yesterday.
So cool.
But this one's so cool. And what's the name of this one?
This is a really cool one. So a couple of years ago, this was known as Philodendron goldii. But it recently got reclassified into Thaumata phylum.
Right.
Has the more tree-like growth.
Yeah, I wouldn't think it's a philodendron.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But this one now is Thaumata phylum spruceanum. So you kind of get the like finger-like growth.
Right. Yeah. The leaves are really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And there is more Jungle Boogie.
Yeah, Jungle Boogie. This Alocasia Sabrina.
Yes. I have one too. I love the stems.
Mm-hmm.
Like a leopard kind of?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
And
Alocasia Lutea too.
Again, what's the name?
Alocasia Lutea.
Lutea. Okay. The leaves are really cool. Oh, but they're huge. And more burly marks.
Over here. This is Sansevieria spicta, so it kind of grows up more upright.
Mm-hmm.
They recently discovered that some Sansevieria are actually really closely related to Dracaena, which is really cool. You can kind of actually see the resemblance in this, but the flowering structure is really similar too.
Right.
That's a cool one. And then these ones are really cool too. This is Sansevieria kirkii, and the variety is Pulchra or Coppertone. So
yeah.
It kind of has that, like, it looks dead almost, but just has that natural grayish tone.
Cause I didn't notice this one until later.
And then here's another really cool one. This is Sansevieria golden flame.
Mm-hmm.
So as it matures, it actually will start to look like a flame. The variegation is really distinct in this. Kind of almost sometimes the whole leaf will be yellow, which is cool.
Right. I think I got mine in San Diego last month.
They're really cool.
But online, it's kind of expensive.
Yeah. That's a cool one.
And what's the huge one here?
Yeah, this is Anthurium. Salvinii.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a super fairly large variety of bird nest Anthurium.
Mm.
You kind of see like the span in here. It's like very large compared to my hand.
Ooh, wow. Yeah. Is it for sale or?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Do you have King Anthurium?
We don't right now. We did have some like littler ones a couple of months ago.
Oh, I see.
They did go very quickly.
Because at the Pisto, like they have one, but they have two actually. Mm-hmm. But the smaller one is not even for sale.
They have a little cute one in there.
Yeah.
Sink. And we got these little cuties. This is Zamofolia zamacolcus. This is a ZZ plant.
Yes.
ZZ raven.
Mm-hmm.
So it starts out green and then it hardens off into a blackish color. Really cool plant. And then we have the Metallica palm.
Right.
I'm not sure the like entire name of this species.
Uh-huh.
Really cool.
Yeah.
Really, like fishtail like growth.
Yeah, the shape is very interesting.
Yeah, and as they get like older, the foliage will look very metallic and shiny.
Oh, okay.
And then we got the pretty Sansevieria sayuri.
Mm-hmm.
Nice white variegation.
Yeah.
It's like almost all white. And this is another cool bird nest Anthurium too. This is Anthurium plaumanii.
Mm-hmm.
These are a really cool type of epiphytic Anthurium.
Mm-hmm.
So this one in particular can go a little longer between waterings. Oh, I see. We recommend like every 10 to 14 days.
Oh, okay.
They do hold a little more water in the roots and in the foliage.
Right.
They have that like nice ruffle on it.
Hmm. Yeah. Yeah. The ruffle leaves.
Real pretty.
And I see that you have a lot of hanging plants here.
Yeah. So you have like the Acianthus or the Black Pagoda. It's a lipstick plant. So they have a really nice like red backing.
Right.
And then we have the Cerapegia woodyi, or the String of Hearts. Really pretty plant.
Yeah. So yeah, I told you earlier that I feel like String of Hearts, they all look different because my, I think the leaves are thinner and not as big as this one.
Yeah, there are definitely a couple of like different greenhouse varieties or like even some hybrids. This is the pretty like typical with the like sort of somewhat white veining. And there's some that are a little rounded at the edge versus the point. And they're all silver. And that one variety is called Silver Glory.
Oh.
It's really pretty, but the leaves are a little thinner too, which is
really
cool. I know a lot of times there's a little hybrid between the two, and they can get that thinner leaf.
Do you have the variegated ones?
The which one?
Variegated String of Hearts.
No, I wish. Those are really pretty.
Oh, yeah.
I love when they have like the pinkish hue to it.
Right,
the ones are really cool.
Yeah. Here's a curly lipstick plant.
Curly lipstick. They're fuzzy too.
Right. So, how do you source your plants? Like, is it more like ordering from the menu, that kind of thing, or do you request plants?
We request some plants. We work with like a variety of like local growers, some from Florida, some from California. We usually just maintain a relationship with those growers, and we usually get some pretty awesome stuff in.
Right. What's like trending or what's popular right now?
I would say the most popular and requested plant is probably Philodendron Pink Princess.
Right.
Another one actually I've gotten a lot of requests for today is Anthurium clarinervum.
I saw one at Hammer and Vine. Was it? Yeah.
Yeah. They're
129.
Yeah, they're very hard to find. I found that that variety is actually very commonly cultivated in Europe.
Oh, okay.
Which like there's some plants that are really easy to find.
Right,
here,
I know.
Super hard to find here.
Yeah.
Same with Calathea orbifolia. That's another popular.
Right.
One.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So like when people request plants, like what's your typical answer? Like, oh, I'm gonna try to get them for you, or no, we don't.
Usually, I'll like say if we do get them in or not. There's some that we usually don't ever see. Usually, we're open on Thursdays, and usually that's when we have our like new plants in.
Right.
Just because they're so popular, we don't do any holds, so we just try to keep it fair for everyone to come and get what they were looking for.
Right.
Do you
think the indoor plant community is getting bigger and bigger, and houseplants are getting more and more popular?
Yeah, I feel like it's definitely having like a resurgence of just like very high density of just like. Community has gotten so much larger. Even just in the past couple months, it's gotten like probably double in size.
Do you think it has to do with social media?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, Instagram has definitely played a huge part in that. Just like seeing all the different plant pages, seeing people connect with each other just over plants is really special.
I had an email communication with Anit from NC Tropicals, and she said it's crazy. Like years ago, she had to throw away her pink princess because she's just had too many, and no one wanted to buy it. And now it's like, oh, people want the
pink. Yeah, she can't keep up anymore. It's
yeah, exactly.
And she just works by herself too, which is insane to me.
Yeah,
she's a very, very awesome grower and woman. Really admire her.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you so much for showing us that you have a lot of cool plants.
Thanks.
Yeah, thank you. Bye.